on this week's show, we'll talk to Nick Nolte about his new film, Warrior. And we'll talk to the guys behind the new film, Corner Store. And we'll take a bite out of summer with Shark Night 3D. All that and a whole lot more when Movie Show Plus returns.
Paxil is a drug approved for the treatment of various forms of depression. However, a recent study suggests that women taking Paxil while pregnant, as compared to other antidepressants, may be twice as likely to have children born with birth defects, heart defects, or primary or persistent pulmonary hypertension in newborns. Never discontinue taking any medication without consulting a physician.
If you were taking Paxil while pregnant and your child is born with a birth defect, heart defect, or PPHN, call 800-910-4190 for a free evaluation.
Out of her own need for staying connected and frustration of not really knowing how to use and maintain her computer, Florence Henderson sought out a solution and created the Flow Club just for you. Just pick up the phone and you'll be connected to a friendly North American technician. With your permission, they will connect to your computer and fix your problem or answer your questions right before your eyes. It's fast, it's so easy, and it's completely safe and secure. For just $24.95 a month, you can call the Flow Club whenever you want and take as much time as you need. There is no appointment scheduling and no one comes into your home. There are no costly fees or upsells. You get your question answered and your problem fixed on the spot by a caring, patient, supportive technician ready to help you at any time. It's like your own personal computer help desk. Call the number on your screen to join the Flow Club now.
Call the number on your screen and open up a whole new world. Join me on the Flow Club.
Growing up, we all want to know the toughest kid in the neighborhood was, right? I want to know the toughest man on the planet is. That's what we're gonna find out.
Brendan, it's me.
Pop, what are you doing here?
Tommy's back.
Did he say if he wants to see me?
I'm proud of you, Tommy. What you did for that kid in the tank.
What was I supposed to do, let him drown?
Tommy Reardon, you saved my life.
Look, Brendan, the bank has gotta go by the new appraisal figures. You're upside down on your mortgage.
How much do you need?
I didn't come here for long, Frank.
I was hoping that
you would train me.
Are you serious?
Do it!
I thought we agreed that we weren't going to raise our children in a family where their father gets beat up for a living.
Brendan, you're a teacher. You got no business in the ring with those animals.
Actually, I used to be one of those animals. I guess I forgot to put that down on my application.
Your performance was just, you can tell truly, like, just from the, was from the heart.
Yeah. Well, I think that's really a requirement of this story is to, you know, we start out on a small scale, you know, Pittsburgh and it's a city, but it's not a city, you know, it's got a country feel to it. Mm-hmm. I mean, the people are all very close. And then it expands out from there. I didn't meet anybody in Pittsburgh that didn't know each other.
Right. You know? It is that type of small community.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah. And the same thing here.
Right.
Yeah.
And then even for your character, I mean, here's this guy who obviously had, you know, issues with his sons and their mom growing up.
Yeah.
But, you know, like with anybody, the older he gets, the more he realizes, I guess you could say, the error of his ways. But he really wants to reunite, but the sons don't want to have anything to do with it.
Well, yeah, I've always felt the most important thing in our structure is the family, unit. And relationships are very difficult. I think probably the biggest task we have in our life journeys is to make our relationships work. And they're difficult to do. I mean, with our children, you know, when you have a child, it's the first time you learn what love is really about. Because you see that child and you know you would give your life up for that child. I don't know if you do that for, you know, your wife, and I don't know if your wife would do that for you.
Some situations, they're like, no.
Most of mine have said, can you make it sooner than later?
Right.
So, you know, Patty, you know, now that he's sober, he recognizes that he created a lot of chaos right. by being obsessed by alcohol. Yeah. And that brings in Moby Dick, you know.
Yes.
He begins mm-hmm. to make the connection mm-hmm. that Moby Dick, that Ahab was obsessed by that white whale, neglected his crew, mm-hmm. didn't care whether they died or not, and he was after that white whale. And, right. and Patty sees that mm-hmm. as an example in his life, right. that he neglected his sons mm-hmm. so he could win and have them win the championships, and he ignored everything else
right.
and obsessively got in the bottle. Mm-hmm. And now, you know, he has to try to put it back together.
War hero Tommy Reardon, who has become an overnight sensation, and Brendan Conlon, the physics teacher, they pulled off a miracle.
You can do this. Whatever you say, I can do this.
You got him!
This is impossible! The two men fighting for the championship tonight are brothers!
Go war!
Are we here to win this fight? Because if we're not, I will throw in the towel.
I see a journey. A man
crossing the sands.
A knight.
A warrior. Your paths will merge.
I had never actually ridden a horse before I got there.
Okay.
So I learned mm-hmm. how to ride horses, how to drive the chariot, and I did all of the horse stunts except one where she jumps from the chariot onto the back rope. You know, that one's not me. But the rest of it I did myself.
Oh! Say, that wasn't...
Sorry, no, that would have been... I missed and I got run over by the carriage.
Yeah, that wouldn't have been good.
Problem.
Yeah, yeah. And then I have to ask this, because most people who've never ridden a horse before, it's hard to look like you're... you know, relaxed
riding this thing. Yeah, it's very hard to look relaxed. And you're not relaxed because they're very powerful animals. Mm-hmm. And I learned very quickly that if you are afraid of the horse can feel it, and
yes.
he will not listen to you.
That's
or she.
Right.
They don't care. You really have to strong arm it and teach it who's boss. And it took me a little while to do that. But afterwards, I would be like, yeah, let's go. Gallop across the field. Mm-hmm. I was into it.
Right. And now, here we go. The Conan franchise is back. This mm-hmm. time in 3D.
Yes.
So we get to see everything like... thrown
coming
right
at you. Yep. I'm really happy with the way that they did it, and I'm glad that they kept the blood and the gore and the beheading, and it's really, you know, it's mm-hmm. an R-rated movie.
Yeah.
And I'm proud that they kept it that way rather than sort of trying to make it a little bit lighter and sneak into the PG-13 mm-hmm. range. I think that's what Conan is meant to be,
right.
really.
Oh, fantastic. Well, when you come to Detroit, we don't have many caves. We do have some fun places for you to go.
But you also have the Detroit Lions, and I really love football. Football's my favorite sport
ever. Oh, really?
Ever. Yes. I just played in the Pigskin Pro-Am
for
Madden, and it was so exciting because I got to play with Kurt Warner and Dan Marino and Jerry Rice.
Oh, jeez.
Tony Dungy coached my team.
I dare say you got every little boy's dream.
Oh, I'll take it.
Come to Detroit, we'll get you Detroit Lions tickets.
I'm serious. I really, really, really want to go.
I know.
This is being recorded, right?
Yes.
Okay.
And I know the owners of the Detroit Lions. We can get you tickets.
I would love that.
You're sought to enslave all of Hyboria.
No man should live in chains.
Yeah, come on.
Run from me, and I will tear apart the mountains to find you. I will follow you to hell.
Thank you.
And right now we're here with one of the stars of Corner Store. This is Trevion. Good to see you.
Good to be here.
Now I've got to ask you, this was your first movie. Mm-hmm. How did you get involved?
My dad is actually the second producer, so I sat in on the casting and I said, let me try. And when they let me try, they said he's perfect for the role. So
now for those of you out there wondering, is nepotism alive in Hollywood or Detroit movies? Yes, it is. Just look at the credits of my show at the end. Also, now tell me about your character. I mean, this guy is kind of like a little, I don't want to say troublemaker, but a kid who just seems to get into trouble.
Yeah, he does stuff that he knows he's not supposed to do, but just for the fun of it, because he's a kid, he does it, and it was a lot of fun.
All right. Now, I've got to ask you, how many of your friends have seen this movie?
All my contacts and my phone and my mom's phone, their moms, yeah, everyone.
And what have they all said to you about it?
They said it was a funny film.
Hey, tell me about all the folks you had involved with this.
Well, we had a whole team of people to come together, filmmakers from Saginaw, Clinton, Spec Howard's PA. So we had a collaboration of a lot of different producers as well as filmmakers here in Michigan. And we wanted to bring back a whole Motown sound and a whole Motown movement. So it was a collective agreement, and we had a lot of good people that worked on the film.
All right, yeah, speaking of which, I know one of the guys, Mike Moner, who's been a comic here forever. Tell us about him. I mean, he's very funny. Him and his group there, those are those guys who you knew growing up, always hanging out in front of the store on the corner.
That's right. I mean, every day on the set, it was like a whole comedy show. I mean, Mike Bonner, Martini Harris, Shawnee D, Bill Hill, those guys kept us rolling on a day-to-day basis. And it was a pleasure. It was actually like a godsend to be able to get those type of people here in the film.
Now, something else about this movie is that was really nice is it takes place in the neighborhood, but it's not a hood movie.
Yeah, that's right. Well, basically, we wanted to make a comedy. We wanted to be able to tell a tale about a community, like a village to raise a child, take a village to raise a child, and we wanted to do it in a form of comedy. You know, there's a lot of crime that's in the city of Detroit. We want to show something different, you know, get the city back moving and having something to laugh at, and that's exactly what we put together.
And also, I got to ask you, I mean, as far as a budget for promotion, I mean, there wasn't a big one. There were no big studios behind you. But you guys have had a great grassroots following of this film. Tell me about some of the things you did to get people out to see the film.
Well, basically, you know, we had a street team that go out. Everybody that was part of the cast and crew, they got out and they supported, their family supported. The word of mouth spread around because Corner Store started way back in 2009 of knowing that something like that was going to happen. And once we filmed it and everybody just caught the Corner Store bug and it was just an easy film to get out here and promote. So we had a lot of different favors that was pulled in from every walk when it comes to media. Everybody wanted to cover the story, and it just felt good because it seemed like, you know, the new Motown was coming back home, and that's what we wanted to get that feeling back anyway. Yes.
And as far as folks here locally, if they want to go see it, where do they go?
Well, they go to the AMC Star Theater in Southfield and AMC John R. in Madison Heights.
Welcome back to Movie Show Plus. Greg Russell here. Just when you thought, can they take it any further? Well, yes, they can. I'm talking about Final Destination. The new one, Final Destination 5, is now showing at your local theaters. Let's check it out now. Poor guy. I mean, he starts out, he's like the great guy. You know what I mean?
He's got it all together.
Yeah.
He's figured, he knows what he wants in life, he knows how to get it, and then the most horrible things happen to him.
Mm-hmm.
And he just tries to make sense out of it, and there's no explanation, and he becomes unhinged.
Yeah, just a little, like I said, just to say the least. Anytime you bring, you know, it's great when one guy shows up with a six-pack of beer, and then your guy goes, basically, I got something better.
Yeah.
And pulls out his fifth of whatever it is, but
that's where I'm at. And you totally get it as soon as I
know.
Pick up scotch.
Olivia wants to party.
And then for you guys, I mean, when you finally got to see this whole thing all put together, what was it like for you to watch it? I mean, just seeing certain things that may have happened to your characters and what happened to other people.
It's strange watching yourself die, you know, and then literally to have it come jump off the screen right at you in 3D.
Yeah.
It's intense. After seeing it, everybody just jumped up. Mm-hmm. At how the 3D in particular is
right.
Stunning. It's just incredibly well done, and our director, Steve Quayle,
yeah.
learned from the master himself, Jim Cameron.
Oh.
For 20 years.
Wow.
He was, you know, right-hand man.
Okay.
So it's a thrill to see.
Yeah, you have always expectations of a movie, and with this movie, it definitely surpassed my expectations. Right. It's just, like Miles said, it's a great ride. Your adrenaline goes throughout the whole movie, and it's fun because you have this great suspense, and you don't know what's going to happen, and it draws the audience in, and I'm a big fan of that. I love the suspense of it.
And you have anything to say, since you're from Windsor, like you said, right there at Detroit?
I know.
Anything back to the folks?
I love Detroit. I love going home. I was just home not too long ago, about a month ago, and... I try to get back there as much as possible. Windsor, Detroit, that's my home.
That's us. We're
together.
All right.
You're not supposed to be here, so let death have somebody else in your place.
Wait a minute. We kill someone, we get their life?
You'll have perfect vision. I'll be right back.
Help me! Help me!
Paxil is a drug approved for the treatment of various forms of depression. However, a recent study suggests that women taking Paxil while pregnant, as compared to other antidepressants, may be twice as likely to have children born with birth defects, heart defects, or primary or persistent pulmonary hypertension in newborns. Never discontinue taking any medication without consulting a physician.
If you were taking Paxil while pregnant and your child is born with a birth defect, heart defect, or PPHN, call 800-910-4190 for a free evaluation.
Have you or a loved one been seriously injured or killed as a result of a gas pedal or floor mat malfunction? More than 4 million Toyota and Lexus vehicles have been recalled for defective gas pedals and floor mats that can cause uncontrolled acceleration, resulting in serious injury and death.
Call 1-800-945-4853.
If you or a loved one has been seriously injured in an accident as a result of one of these defects, you may be entitled to substantial financial compensation.
Don't delay. Call now at 1-800-945-4853.
An important alert for people using the drug Avandia. The diabetes drug Avandia has been linked to serious heart-related injury and even death. If you or a loved one used Avandia and suffered a heart attack, heart failure, stroke, or heart-related death, you may be entitled to substantial financial compensation.
Call 1-800-945-1258.
Recent congressional reports and FDA studies have found an increased risk of heart attacks and heart failure in patients using the drug Avandia. Time to file a claim is limited.
Call 1-800-945-1258.
If you owe over $15,000 in taxes, listen to this.
We owe the IRS $24,000, but we only pay $2,000.
We owe the IRS $200,000, but we only paid $40,000.
Call now for a free, no-obligation consultation and reduce your tax debt.
We owe the IRS $3 million, but we paid less than $1 million.
Call 888-236-5121 now.
Welcome back to more Movie Show Plus. Greg Russell here, and right now, here's a movie that's going to be opening up soon at your local theaters.
Hands up!
We are going up to Lake Crosby to Sarah Howski's house.
Are you ready for the lake?
Let's go!
Room for one more?
Yeah, totally.
Cool. Good boy.
Oh.
You guys have fun back there.
Not quite what we had in mind. Let's rock it out.
Your house is on an island?
Oh, it's going to be a good weekend.
You want to hit that island? Your secret's safe with me, man.
Did have to go in the water in Louisiana, swamp water. Now, I grew up in LA, I'm a city girl. Did not know about the creatures and the lake. And it was funny because I was shooting a scene, and I'm about to get in the water and hear all these gasps on the other boats. And I'm like, what's going on? I look out, 10 feet from my boat, they're like, it's a log. I couldn't comprehend what I saw. It was a 14-foot alligator.
I actually went through like 3 weeks of wakeboarding training to really learn how to get the nuances of riding the board, not being afraid, not getting scared. And it was a lot of fun, you know? It was really cool.
Saltwater lake.
I don't know how the hell they got in here.
Maybe someone put them there.
Promotional consideration for Movie Show Plus is brought to you by A Dream Limousine. For every special occasion, weddings, graduations, or just a night on the town, A Dream Limousine will give you the star treatment. Give them a call at 734-542-6800 or go to their website at adreamlimo.com. For a great night out on the town, there's only one place to go. That's Top of the Class, Detroit's first cabaret-style nightclub. Located on the city's east side, it's stylish and classy for the mature crowd. Every Friday night, get your hustle on with Detroit's own Fast Freddy and stay and dance the night away. And on Saturday, come back and dance some more to the music of one of our top DJs or a live band. We also have the best food in town. Top of the Class, located at 10820 Whittier in Detroit. Call 313-527-0656 for more information. We're also the home of the free birthday party. Top of the Class, Detroit's top nightclub.
And hey, you guys enjoy, and we'll see you next time right here on Movie Show Plus.
Who are you really, Brent?
We all have our secrets. Don't we, Ethan?